فينا بيت الباري violence society. They live their lives based on robbery. Stopping convoy that go up down, they stop them, they rob what they have, they get their women slaves, they kill their people, they give the money, that's how they live. This is a society that, and then more than that, those who are known to be leaders, those are who are basically gang members. If you want to say gang leaders, not gang members really, gang thugs. Why? Because those are the most toughest, the most violent, and the most ruthless people leading. And those are the people who should be feared. Okay, that's of course, this picture is not an absolute, because there is no absolute picture in anything. There's always a mixture of things. But generally, you want to get the idea of how things were as far as humanity. Humanity didn't mean anything. Human beings didn't mean anything. From the poor levels of society, from the slaves of society. If we were to say, well, these slaves really, these shackles on, I always said that, the shackles on these slaves, these chains that these slaves were chained with, wallah, they are medals, they are iron medals for the entire humanity. The entire humanity, not only Muslims, the entire humanity should stand in honoring the shackles of those slaves, because these shackles were actually iron medals. Freedom is looking for those kinds of slaves who people thought they were slaves, yet they were absolutely free. This is not our topic. Let's go ahead. Those poor people, poverty. And poor people usually are affected by their environment. And you all know that. May Allah make you all rich. But I'm sure some of you are poor people. And poverty unfortunately reflects on the poor people with their education, with the level of people they're around with, usually, with the way they dress, with the way they walk, with the way they eat, with the way everything, really all aspects of social aspects are affected by the economical status of the person. This is a social fact. Of course, did not play very well at all. Because people of Quraysh, you know, if you live in a place, you don't want to come and be around those other people. That was one other reason for the Kuffar not to come to the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. You are surrounded by those people who are nothing. They are poor, they don't have anything. Because at that time society was based on how much money? Not at that time only, huh? Sometimes up to these times. People based on how rich are people based on how bad is your checking account? Let me save your account. Huh? All these things. How much money do you have? This is fitr for only. I said that this before, but this is a fitr of Fir'aun. Fir'aun, when Musa Islam came to him, he told, don't know if you have any, why when the Quran mentions this actually, by saying Fir'aun and that, Fir'aun saying, why didn't he have gold and silver and all these things with him? Because if you have really a problem of Allah, then you have lots of gold. Then you see that. Because he's telling based on what he sees, right? Those poor people that the Prophet
surrounded himself with, not saying not exactly by tourists, but he just picked the poor people. Those are the people that have the hearts of Allah that are open to Islam, came and sponsored this deen, really, in their strength, and they propagated the deen. Of course, a part of it, like I said, has always many, maybe, even though unintentionally, but it's got many negative impacts on the personality. And it affects them. Therefore, Al-Imam Ali Amir al-Mu'minin radiallahu anhu wa ba'a said, لو كان الفقر رجلا لقتلته. If the poverty was a man, I would have killed that man. الفقر almost كفر. You see people nowadays, they go to attract those people of low socioeconomic levels, and they try to change their mind, say, you know, you shouldn't be Muslim, you should be something else, you should not. Because why? They're using here, here, heat. Here's food, here's this thing. They're using the money. But subhanAllah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala always has wisdom in things that are made. Anyway, some of the kuffar of Quraysh, of the most great people supposedly of Quraysh, they came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and fortunately, I know Allah has said, actually they were not believers. There are two narrations. Either they are the kuffar, or they were the mu'allaqa qulubuhum. Mu'allaqa qulubuhum means some people who were actually kind of paid money to say, well, you know, think about it. Islam is good. Here's some money, here's something. Think about it. Maybe you accomplish that. You are in the neutral zone. You're not there and not here. That is basically mu'allaqa qulubuhum. So, the says, either mu'allaqa qulubuhum or some of those who are kuffar, killing kuffar, killing the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. That's it, bro. We're here in this Quran. Okay, how much power can we send? Because the Quran, لَهُمْ عَلَاوَ وَقَرَارُ. As you know, the Quran is sweetness. For those who can really have taste to it. You have to open not only your ears, you have to open your heart and mind and soul to the Quran. And therefore nowadays many times we get the Quran by what? Oh, mashallah, he has a very good voice. Remember that? So, listening to the music. And many people actually, you see that many times, that they judge basically on the voices of the reciters. Maybe one of the reciters is saying it right, the other is saying it wrong, but it doesn't matter. Alhamdulillah, voice is good. That's how we judge. So maybe we should start looking, because reciting the Quran is not about the voices. Reciting the Quran is recited how the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam recited it. So a kuffar, they were, first we don't want to get close to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is this, you know? And then the Quran started coming into their minds. They couldn't help it. You know how something attracts you? And you can't help it, just kind of gets in your mind? Like when the medication goes into the stomach of a patient. Can you stop it once it goes there? You can. Huh? And that's how the Kufar of Quraysh, they presented Islam, and the life of the Prophet, they didn't offer, they presented Islam, they hated Islam, but they couldn't take it but to listen to this great Quran Azim. Coming with challenge them with what they know best, the Arabic language at that time, came to them, so they had to listen. And once they listen, it starts coming in. And when it came in, they said, you know, together, they said, maybe let's go to Muhammad. Let's go to him and tell him, look, we want to listen to your Quran a little bit, because it sounds good. Huh? We want to listen to you, but one condition. What is the condition? Condition is those people.